A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away. Hello everyone and welcome to Star Wars Dark Forces, the first entry in the Star Wars Dark Forces Jedi Knight Jedi Academy series, and the first game to feature Cal Katarn, now a smuggler, later a Jedi, but more about that in a different game, Dark Forces. The new Order of the Empire stretches its evil clutches across the galaxy, consuming planets with devastating results. Through many struggles, the Rebel Alliance has learned of a new Imperial battle station, the Death Star, with enough power to destroy an entire planet. Unable to acquire the plans to the deadly space station, the Rebels have employed the skills of Kyle Katarn. Known to most as a mercenary for hire, Katarn is a rogue figure who has a partial alliance with the Rebels. Armed only with a blaster pistol and an intimate knowledge of Imperial methods, Katarn prepares to infiltrate the Imperial base in which the plans are kept. Yes, we have to recover Death Star plans. I'll comment a little bit more on that later, due to recent events and also due to a couple of other things. But for now, let's watch this beautiful text sprawl disappear into space. Here we are. We play as Cal Katarn, and we are armed only with a blaster pistol and intricate knowledge of Imperial methods. So let's intricately kill everyone here and then make our way through here and look for those Death Star plans. Yeah, obviously now that Rogue One is out, this is a little bit obsolete, but it's still a Star Wars legend, I suppose. Originally, there were a lot of stories about people stealing Death Star plans. In fact, there are so many that someone just said, if you want to invite everyone over for dinner, whoever stole Death Star plans, you better have a large dining table. But I think the idea was that different groups stole different like parts of the Death Star plans. I don't know what. It was all a bit weird. It was the Star Wars Extended Universe, so what do we expect, really? Also, let's kill you guys. The Stormtroopers here, they're your basic enemy for the game. There's a lot of them, they all look the same. As they, well, sort of, kind of. Well, the basics do, Stormtroopers always look the same. These guys here are actually not the weakest enemy, that's the Imperial Officer. Imperial Officer has one hit point less. And also, switch the light on here. And also, only has a blaster pistol, which is a weaker weapon. Oh, why didn't I do that? I don't know, but never mind. We're going to try that again. But they might have keycars on occasion, so always shoot. Well, then again, you really want to shoot everyone anyway, so it's not like that really makes much of a difference, does it? Okay, so let's try that again. What we get there is a complete health riff. We don't need that all that desperately, but I kind of want to have it now. So let's be careful here. This game has very slippery, slidey physics. Yeah, every level is an ice level, and your feet are made of grease. It's really easy to slide off. So, which makes jumping here a little bit difficult. But hey, this game does have jumping, which wasn't standard when this came out. This game is often referred to as a Doom clone, or I guess you can also call it a Hexen or a Heretic clone. But it does have Wolfenstein 3D's life system, but the thing is, as a clone, it's a bit unfair. It does bring some new things to the table. You could look up and down, and you could... Was someone still shooting at me here? Never mind. And you could actually move up to different levels, different floors. That wasn't standard at the time, so keep that in mind, and now you're dead. So let's get the shields here. I'm actually re-recording this because there were audio sync issues the first record. Also, you can destroy these mouse droids here, not in this mod here. I'm using the the DarkXL XL engine mod. And now you're dead. But generally spoken, you can. I think before I go down there, we will get up here. Yeah, unfortunately, but I could fix that. Thankfully, it didn't affect any video after the third video. Let's collect the stuff here. May as well fill up my shields. I don't need the ammunition, but I still want to have it for now. Because ammunition and everything, including their lives, they all carry over, so you do want to make sure you do have enough of all of that for later stages. So, don't really need that shield. So let's just jump back and let's jump over here. Does that actually get us? And yeah, that does get us something, I think. But maybe not really. Anyway, let's jump over here. Wasn't there something here? I could have sworn there was. Maybe not here, but maybe at a different area. We'll see. Let's keep an eye open for potential platforms. Oh yeah, this looks good to me. So let's take another leap here. I can jump really far, so never underestimate that. Oftentimes too far, but that's all right. So here we go. Headlight on. These headlights do use battery, and let's activate this. So be aware of that. Let's lower this barrier here. And then we can find this massive glowing imperial door. Anything here? Yeah, I think this just leads us back. This is a secret area. The game has many such secret areas. I'm not going to find all of them, but oftentimes they contain extra resources, so it's quite beneficial to find all of them. Oftentimes they can also be well guarded, so depending on how experienced you are, you might lose more stuff than you've gained from finding them. So they're a bit of a mixed blessing at times. These here are the infrared goggles. They're not really infrared goggles, they're actually like light amplifying goggles. And they actually make you see in the dark properly, not just... Everything turns green, but apart from that, you can see properly. This is not quite the same. The headlight is literally just that. It's like a head torch. So let's collect this. Ooh, and here is a portrait of the Emperor. 2, in fact, and an extra life. Yeah, this game uses the Wolfenstein life system. So yeah, there's actually checkpoints, but to reload at the checkpoint, you have to sacrifice a life. Actually, just kill yourself. Just refill your health and shields to half, so it can be a bit of a mixed blessing. And if you lose too many lives early on, then you might be unable to even complete the game, so you can actually get yourself into a corner. So it's a bit can be a bit of an issue, and this game is overall not easy, especially if you're inexperienced. It's not very forgiving for beginners. So wait, no, that's not what we want to do. So I did have a supercharge here, but that ran out now. I actually forgot about that noise. But someone mentioned that in the comment last time. So we have some additional stuff here. Nice. None of which we need, but that's fine. And dead. And dead. Oh, how did you say halt? I wasn't even there. But anyway, we've got this really nice Death Star. Sort of, not really wireframe, but you know what I mean, model. But we don't want that. We want to shoot this guy here and kill all of you. And then we're going to grab your stuff. And wait, didn't... Yeah, there's... Oh yeah, this is the switch. Almost forgot about that. There we go. This will go up very slowly and dramatically and reveal the Death Star plans, which looks like a glowing red chip or so. So let's grab them.
Get to my ship.
Yep. The ship is the Moldy Crow, which hasn't been named as such yet, but will be so later in the tie-in novels and later games. Well, let's get out of here. And then we're good. Well, after of course we all of these guys here. There we go. Death Star plans have been stolen and the good guys win. After they kill this commando here. That's our ship. Yeah, that was the first episode, not too long. Later ones will be longer, but we'll see about that. Thanks for watching, and I shall see you then. Take care and goodbye.